Welcome, race fans, to the final round of racing in the 2009 Monster Energy Motocross Nationals. Brian Koster and Mark Travers in the booth. MX2 class coming out of stage. And of course, Brian, four motos today here at the Walton Transcan, two in the MX2 class and two in the MX1 class. Big story this week. This has been the week of amateur racing. The amateur national championships have been going on all week. It culminates with the pro racing here today, Brian, and it has been a spectacular week.
The weather gods have been in our favor for sure. The amateurs had a great week of racing, some new champions crowned, but it's all about the pros, and that's today's Sunday drafts.
Well, the 18th annual Transcan, Brian, as they call it, a celebration of Canadian motocross, takes place at the Lee Family Farm, and it is an amazing piece of property. You see all the amateur pits lined up here, of course, little tribute to JSR and Blair Morgan there in the amateur ranks. But let's get to the track, Brian. A truly, truly remarkable outdoor track with great elevation, choice dirt. You talked about this year, about the track preparation and the fact that they're making it a real fast circuit, not as many ruts this year.
Yeah, and a lot of flow, so the riders having fun, able to actually use the speed of the bike. They can make tons of ruts in these corners. This year, it's a little more flat and fast.
And you saw in the background that sea of humanity, the number of people that travel from coast to coast to race here. Yeah. It really is the biggest motocross race, the biggest outdoor motocross race in the country. Seeing the boys on the line, why don't we get onto the track with Ryan Gold, the MXP helmet cam, and let's check it out.
Yeah, he's on a YZ450 Yamaha. This is after the big, fast back straightaway series of ups and downs. Only a few ruts on the track into the big step up. This is for the pros only here. Land, another thing here, you jump, get air, land. Look how open it is. It's basically point it and pin it through here. In years past, we've had tons of ruts. This is like the roller coaster section. A lot of passing going in there. Guys are gonna be in the air, not able to brake. So the riders that can stay low and stay on the brakes. That was a great shot of the natural double. Famous jump here, Walton. Another little double, get light here through this new tree section. This whole area will be full of what we call the tree people for the race. Lots of passing here, inside, outside, a beautiful little double. But right here, new, is this off camber. And the guys that can come in wide are gonna pass the guys that come in tight. Guys falling down everywhere in that off camber. Goldie made it look easy there with a nice line, but you get into race conditions and guys start pushing, there's gonna be a lot of soil samples out there.
Down here at the start of the first MX2 motor with Parker Allison, currently sitting 10th on our points. Parker, buddy, the intensity starts to rise right here. What goes through your mind before the gate drops?
The adrenaline starts pumping. I'm thinking about just myself on this starting line. Me to the first corner first.
Hey, that sounds easy enough. We got two motos left in the series, buddy. What are you going for this weekend?
Top 10. That's what I'm going for. Consistent top 10 both motos. Get a good start. That's the key.
And you and your brother really like this place.
We do. We like this place. It's just like our house, and it's my soil.
All right, buddy. Good luck this weekend.
Thanks a lot.
All right, guys. Get it back out to the booth. Keep an eye on the number 36, Parker Allison.
His brother, number 21, Jared Allison. They are mirror image twins on that Blackfoot support team new this year. There's number 66, Dustin Hayes, going out for his hot lap. Stick around.
Welcome back to the Transcan, Walton, Ontario, for the final round of Monster Energy Motocross Nationals 2009. My goodness, the Julies are heading out to the track, Ryan. The 30 board is going up, and we are getting ready to race. First MX2 moto of the day, and it will be brought to you by MX Performance Magazine, the number one motocross magazine in the country. Great shot of number 14, Teddy Mayer, on the inside gate pick, Brian. Remember, with a good moto here, he could clinch the title.
Yeah, definitely, and right beside him is Jeremy Medaglia. So we've got some fast players on the inside. Traz, the gate is gonna go down now. Here we go, the drag race is on. Mayer with a good jump, but look who it is. It is Blackfoot rider number 12, Kyle Bead, with a commanding run of the stripping hole shot.
with that huge sweeping left-hander, Brian, one of the largest corners we've ever had for a hole shot, funnels the boys into what they call the Yamaha Sugar Bowl up by the lake, and we have got a battle for third place. Looks like Mayer, Nye, and Spencer Knowles.
Tight racing right off the top tracks. Knowles, probably the most impressive rookie of the year on that number 72 clear rope bike. Oh, tension between number one and number 14. Teddy Mayer holds on, but really like Eric Nye this year, Travs, he always seems to respond when he's passed. He doesn't lie down, man. He is always on the go, looking to steal that position back.
One of the nicest guys in the pits, but get him out of the track, Brian, and he is all elbows. There's number 12, Kyle Beaton, in the lead. It looks like the number 14 bike of Teddy Mayer has gotten by the number 22 of Brock Hoyer for second place, and now is the battle for third. Nye on the outside, Brian, we're seeing right now the speed they're carrying in these corners. Normally, that is a run-it-out corner.
Wow, Nye just came through there so fast, and then he hit that slick stuff because they got to lay some water down out here to keep the dust down, and Nye had both wheels going in no man's land, kept the gas on, kept it upright. Sweet pass.
The boys funneling over the monster finish line, one of the best scrubbing jumps in the country. Brian, we'll see that through the course of the race to the battle for fourth place. Two hot young Canadian motocross pilots for a big wall hit. Knowles on the outside, Hoyer going underneath as they double over this new section, Brian, into the off camber.
Wow, there Knowles showing exactly what I was talking about with the helmet cam. You can cut across, puts himself right in front of Brock Hoyer. Excellent pass for fourth place from Spencer Knowles, man, and he has showed unbelievable speed this year. He's got a bunch of hole shots too, so he's not afraid or intimidated off the start.
To our lead package, we saw Beaton in first place, Mayer in second place, back to the battle for, oh my goodness, the number 19, the South African. Karen Fitzgerald is going bar to bar with Harvey. This is for fifth place.
Wow, unbelievable. Such poise from these riders to race in such close proximity, and look at Harvey just pinning it in the crouch. A real fast, long track this year, I tell you. These guys can really get some miles an hour out on this track. Beautiful shot of Beats, just in control out front through this off camber. Here comes Mayer, second. Get poised to lock up the championship if he can hold this moto. Eric Knight dives in this. Oh, and Knight, low slides. This is such a difficult corner. You can see Beaton and Mayer make it look easy. Loses one position right there. He's up and running, kept the motorcycle running, so Eric and I very lucky. We'll see if he can salvage third here.
That inside rut looked like it ended, Brian. He had nowhere to go but nose down. Look at this battle with a pair of teams. Oh, Hoyer off the track, and a great line for Evenu as they come into that off camber.
Evenu teammates there just shoves Hoyer right out of the picture. Hoyer has to relent the position. But look at number 16, Jeremy Medaglia, with a dreadful start, sitting 14th right now. But look at Beats just shredding this place up. Look at the crowd here. They are loving what they're seeing. Jared Beaton on as he goes around, one of the most personable young kids on the circuit. And just a darling to the crowd, coast to coast. Mayer poised for that championship, Travs.
Back to the battle for third place. We've got the number 19 of Karen Fitzgerald in third, and there's the number one of Eric Nye, who was in third over the natural double. One of the best places to watch the race from, Brian. A great jump. One of the most famous ones in Canadian motocross. Spencer Knowles now has number 24, the leading edge Kawasaki of Nick Evenu, as they double over the natural double. Coming inside, what a great pass for Nick Evenu.
Heads up, cut over for Evenu, stayed low, landed on the inside, and that's a tough pass to make coming off that natural double. A little bit faster than Spencer Knowles, I think, most of the year. But Knowles, I tell you, only 16 years old. That kid's got a bright future.
To the battle for 10th place, the number 870 Yamaha, the American, that's Jenerich, and number 36, Parker Allison, on the wall hit. Oh, what a corner for Allison. He's got the inside line. Now it's going outside into the off-camber, Brian. What a pass.
Yeah, that is a great pass, and what a heads-up move for Allison. You see him knife under. Takes unbelievable skill and coordination to pull that up. Now, there's number 19, the South African, Fitzgerald, and look at this. Nye cannot buy a break. Fitzgerald inherited third when Nye crashed in the off-camber. Nye completely upside down, loses the front end again. He might have too much air pressure in that front tire. He might want to find a new front tire choice for the second moto.
To our leader, number 12, Kyle Beaton on that Red Bull Yamaha. Brian, he has been leading since the opening corner, got the hole shot in total control. If Beats was not injured at the beginning of the season, we would have been seeing a lot of this so far.
For sure. I mean, he started out first moto, the first race, gets a broken wrist, soldier through, rode with the broken bone. The kid's got heart, man, and there's no question about the speed. Ninth place now. Spencer Knowles has worked backwards with some problems, and that looks like Jenerich making the move. The American slowly easing his way up. on these young Canadian riders.
Well, that was a great indication, Brian, of what this track can be like when they can carry speed in those tight corners. Jenneris took that outside line, carried speed, and got by over that scrubber.
He sure did. A nice shot of Fitzgerald riding with unbelievable poise. He's kind of all alone now that nine fell down. Liking what I'm seeing from number 16, though, Medaglie up to 10th place, Travis, making a lot of moves. And look at, there he gets by young Knowles.
Number 12, Kyle Beaton, getting his last lap flag over the finish line. Brian, let's talk about Medaglie, a huge star in the MX2 class after making that move from MX1, privateering it now with Murphy Motorsports with that Bondi engine package. That kid is electric.
Wow, look at him go. He's making another quick move on Jenneris, and I think he's going to knife under here. Jenneris, he should learn to try that move. He's been passed there several times. Medaglie is super fast. Cursed with that bad start here, puts him to ninth. Teddy Mayer is going to clinch the championship here. One more lap to go. Oh, some rare emotion out of Teddy Mayer, liking that a whole lot.
Eighth place on the line, the number 36. That's the Blackfoot Support Yamaha of Parker Allison. Has got Jeremy Medaglie right on his heels. Through that little right-hander, Brian, to the step-up. Oh, and a little bit of a check-off. Oh, what a move from Medaglie. He's got the inside line.
Man, poor Medaglie. He's just praying for more laps, but this moto has ran out on him. He's passing and slicing and dicing big time. Here comes Kyle Beaton. Took the moto win last week at Sandalie. Led the second moto, faded back. Wins here, a little redemption for beating a fence bump, but it's all about number 14, leading edge Kawasaki. Teddy Mayer, finally after four long seasons in Canada, clinches that elusive MX2 crown.
All right, Brian, let's get to our Yamaha leaderboard. Top 10 in the first MX2 moto. Of course, you know about Beaton, Mayer, and Fitzgerald. Harvey in fourth with a great ride. I love Evano, Hoyer, Medaglie, Duravec, Allison, and Jenneris.
Kyle Beaton, another moto win here. That was domination. Got in front, no even looking back.
Yeah, I know. I just got off to that great start, and I just sprinted for the first three or four laps, and then just looked for some smooth lines and just made sure I was consistent, no mistakes, and I think I did that.
Hey, buddy, it's been a long year. We got one moto left. Can we get another win out of you?
I'm hoping so. I don't know. We'll have to see if we get a good start and try to hang on to the guard like we did in Sandalie, and hopefully have some luck on my side.
All right, buddy. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Okay, Fabs, the MX1 boys are out of staging. They're on the line. A few new faces this weekend. The number 108 of Cornell Nemeth from Hungary for his third race here in Canada. And the 159 of Troy Adams on that label at Honda. Number one, Colton Fasciotti, looking very calm. He could clinch the championship with this moto.
Yeah, barring disaster, it is all his. Bobby Kaye battling with Medaglie for third. We're going trackside with Gino Rheingold.
Hey, boys, right down here on the start of the MX1 moto with number 28, Orange Motorsports, Liam O'Farrell, buddy. Having a great season so far. What's going through your mind right here before the gate drops?
Well, it's pretty hot out, so I just want to make sure I'm hydrated. And I'm going to pace myself because I don't want to get dehydrated. And I think I got the speed here. This was my good race last year, so hopefully it can be the good one this year.
The South African Liam O'Farrell is ready to race in the MX1 class. First moto coming up. Welcome back to Walton, Ontario, and the Monster Energy Motocross Nationals first MX1 moto. The boys are on the line, and the Julies are out onto the track, looking quite nice in those black skirts and a brand new 30 board. Brian, we forgot to talk about that. An excellent addition to the series. And this race will be brought to you by Extreme Motocross Apparel. Colton Fasciotti, as we talked about, could clinch the championship with this moto. Tyler Medaglie right beside him on the gate, Brian. I love this shot of the guys all the way down the line. Getting ready to focus down on the gate, and the gate is down, Brian. Coming to that first corner, who's going to get that Royal Distributing Holds? Yeah!
Wow, no false starts, but from third spot over, Dusty Klatt styles his way into the hole shot, but really impressed with number 43, Ryan Millar. He came from the outside, swept in with a great shot. Look at Nemeth, way back. Cornell Nemeth cannot buy a start, but we know he's dangerously fast.
Look at the number 159 of Troy Adams, Brian, on that label at Honda with a dynamite start, busts his way up into second place. You knew this kid was going to be fast. Hasn't raced a lot in the States this season so far, but boy, he got a great start here today.
Yeah, plagued with injuries, he is a threat in the U.S. when he's in top physical shape. A big guy on the bike, so he can really work the front end and get that front end to bite. really well, so knew he would be a threat. Sitting second, didn't quite expect that. We'll see if any of these young Canadians got anything for him. Like Melario, hanging tough in third. There's number seven, always a great starter, Jeff Northrup. And there's Fasciotti with the direction change. Slice and dice into fourth. Colton Fasciotti, I tell you, he has been no doubt the class of the field this year.
What a pass on the inside as the boys scrub over the finish line through the monster lockoff camp. A dynamite pass for Fasciotti moving into fourth place past Norkel, who got a great start. Okay, to our leader, number two, Dusty Clatt, with a good start out there, Brian. Looks like has not gapped Adams as much as I thought. Adams in second place, to Fasciotti in third, Ryan Millar in fourth, Norkel. Then we've got Phillips, that's three KTMs. The number one and two of Bobby Kinnear, and I thought I saw the number 77 Suzuki of Ian Hayden. There he is, Brian.
Yeah, Hayden pulled up by the Ocean Transport Squad, riding Jeremy Medaglia's 450. It was just sitting there collecting dust. Got Ian Hayden in. Hayden rides Snowcross as well for the Ocean Transport team. Look at Fat Yotes, just styling out there. Back to Hayden, really fast. Great to see him back on a 450.
This is the battle for second. Brian Yotes on the outside. Adams with it. It's in the throws it away with a little low slider and that little rutted out section, Brian. Another rut that just kind of ends, fell apart with that front end of Adams.
Oh, unbelievable. I think Adams saw Fasciotti around the outside and just decided to give it a little extra throttle. Low slider down there, and it's very slick under some of that loose dirt.
Picked the bike up and got going. Norkel got by him, and it looked like the number 102 of Bobby K as well got by him, as well as Millar. So, boy, I tell you what, you got to get that bike up and get going quick, or people are going to go by it like crazy.
New bumps added there, too, off of this real steep, like tabletop. There's a roadway underneath. Some riders hate it. Mark Travers, where is Nemeth going? The giant on the motorcycle going into the pit area here on like the second lap. All the way from Hungary. How's that for you?
Tough break for number 108 Cornell Nemeth and that KTM team. Look at Dusty Clatt out in front. But Colton Fasciotti is keeping, oh my goodness, over gorgeous. That step-up jump. Absolutely gorgeous.
Yes, he is. Beautiful on the machine. And you can see the influence from Jean-Sebastian Watt. Up and down Fasciotti this year. Not a good start for number three, Tyler.
Oh boy.
Comedy of errors up front. Number 700. Rife goes down. Phillips got nowhere to go but right over the top of them. That's like eighth, ninth place. Those guys got some soul searching to do, looking for neutral, refiring the bike. They are out of the equation, but it's Bobby Kinnear right now battling with Northrup for third. This is what it's all about for Kinnear. He has to beat Medaglia, and he's doing it right now to try and secure third overall. There's a lot of money at stake for third overall in this championship.
And the battle for the lead, Brian, is not going away. Look at Kinnear on the outside through a very tricky part of the track into this roller coaster section. Woo. Oh my, Bobby K with a dynamite pass moves into third place. But Northrup's not giving up.
Northrup never gives up. He is one of the hardest, most tenacious riders to pass. Oh. We know Bobby Kinnear looks like he can make it stick right now. We know his supercross skills, so no one's going to get the better of him on some of these jumps. He knows how to stay low and get his timing. So Bobby K, a supercross specialist, showing his wares outdoors.
Certainly in the tighter parts of this track, for sure. To our leader, you saw number two, Dusty Clatt out in front, and number one, Fasciotti in second place. Look at the number 28, Liam O'Farrell, the South African with a great line on the outside. Yeah. He gets by the so-called teammate, Millar.
Well, Millar is on the Royal Stripping Factory KTM. Of course, O'Farrell is on that Orange Motorsports KTM. Orange Motorsports, a great off-road dealership. They just love their motorbikes, and they have Kieran Fitzgerald as well. So awesome camaraderie and competition under the yellow KTM tents.
The Ocean Transport Suzukis are out battling. Do you see Kyle?
Yeah.
He's now getting in the mix. Great to see him charging hard as he moves into seventh place. But the battle for the lead is hot.
Oh.
Fasciotti on the inside. No way. Clatt carrying speed on the outside. That's one of the toughest parts of the track, Brian, for sure.
How often have we seen these two in this position? Look at Dusty just killing this track. Fasciotti right there. You know, the motos that Clatt has won, Fasciotti's been right on his fender. A lot of the motos Fasciotti has won. That is just poetry in motion. Back to all the motos Fasciotti's won. He's won by 30, 40 seconds. Phillips out. He's got a problem. He's retiring.
To the number seven, the Royal Distributing KTM of Jeff Northrup, sitting in fourth place right now, Brian. Love this position for Norkel. You talked about a real tough rider to pass and a very experienced veteran on the track. Love that style.
Yeah, really good for him. Hard to kind of beat riders like Fasciotti this year. He has been so mentally and physically prepared. Bobby K doing what he has to do for his championship hopes. third overall, pretty darn good. But Dusty Klatt right now, familiar story, that rear view mirror full of the number one plate.
Brian, as we get into the waning stages of this moto, let's set the story. Fassiotti sitting in second place right now. If he finishes there, we'll clinch the championship. For Klatt, it's all about respect and pride. He wants to win this moto, and he wants to hold off the champion. He's going to finish in second place even if he wins this moto.
Well, true that, but Fassiotti wants to win every moto, too. He is very determined. Look at this. He's not lying down. He wants to win. Now, this is the last lap. I want to talk about the aggression. I want to talk about how the bikes react out on this Walton track. The bikes react totally different between on the gas and off the gas, as well as the chassis needs to be settled using the brakes and to get the traction down. So a lot going on out there that you can't quite see, but these riders are very busy, Travis, with body position, throttle control, braking, and look at the legwork on Fassiotti. He's dashing this way and that. He wants the win. Dusty Klatt, very, very poised, holding back Fat Yotes.
Brian, remember, we were watching a little bit of wheel spin there. Teammates on equally prepared motorcycles, but it's all about the style, completely different styles. Klatt's a little more all over the map. He loves to hang it out a little bit, where Fassiotti is a little more in control.
Yeah, Klatt, I just love the way he rides, love the way they both ride. Another thing here is the ruse factor. Fassiotti's been trying to dodge that ruse, but it is a factor on this fast Walton track. And look at the high speeds around here. This is 1 year at Walton when these boys are tapped everywhere, man. It's been awesome, and look how wide it is. Dusty pulling away right now. Fassiotti's got to get busy if he wants to get first on the back.
Oh, you talked about the roost out there too, Brian. Look at all the rocks on the track, and they're various size rocks. So when you get in behind, you can get pelted in the face. Oh, nice little step-up scrubber.
There he goes.
Fassiotti with the inside line through that little roller section into that huge KTM sweeper, Brian, through the trees. Oh, my goodness. We are coming down to the final two corners. Fassiotti looking for a way around Klatt. Klatt with the inside line. We've got Klatt for trouble.
Oh my God, you're right. Now Klatt carries speed. He loves to flow around the outsides, and sometimes he leaves the inside open with a guy like Fassiotti there, right down to the last corner. Look out! Fassiotti just stuffs himself, parks it. It is all Dusty Klatt out there, Travis. What a moto.
Fassiotti clinches with second place. Brian, let's go to the Yamaha leaderboard, top 10.
Yeah, unbelievable. Kinnear has a great ride, besting Medaglia, like Keys to Quiet Moto in six. Ryan Millar and Chuck Mesley rounded out.
Let's call that the best moto of the season. First MX1 moto here from Walton with our winner, number two, Dusty Klatt. Dusty, what a spectacular race, buddy. You are in super shape. You held off Colton Fassiotti in all facets of the track. You look fantastic doing it.
Yeah, thanks. I mean, my Blackfoot Yamaha just rocked it out of the gate today, and you know, that's what I was looking for forever, and we finally got another one. And you know, it's similar to Edmonton. I just got up front, just tried to ride my own race. And even though he was right there, I just tried to be calm and ride my own race. If he got by me. He was definitely coach pushing me.
Great ride from Dusty Klatt. Here it is. Look how much further Fassiotti jumps down in here. He's got the leg up, crisscrosses, but loses traction, and it's all Dusty Klatt. Great first moto here at Walton. Stick around. The MX2 boys, final moto for them after the break.
This is Walton, Ontario in the 2009 Monster Energy Motocross Nationals. The two beautiful Julies with a brand new Monster 30 board. The 32nd board is up, Brian, and this final moto for the MX2 class this season will be brought to you by SureRide and SureMyRide.ca. Red Julie, or as they're calling her now, Ginger Julie, to five. Back to the riders, Brian, waiting for that 30 board, which was going to five, to sideways. There it is, down at the gate, Brian. Oh, a little bit of a false start there. And the gate is down, Brian, coming to that left-hander. Who's going to get that rule distributing hole? Yeah.
Teddy Mayer gets swallowed up, looks over, looks like those. Oh no, the South African Fitzgerald on the orange Mercer KTM gets that Royal Distributing Hole Truck, just snags it right away from Knowles.
Number 72, Spencer Knowles on that Clearbrook Yamaha has been lightning fast all season long, Brian, showing his wares very well in this class. I've been liking his speed. He has got a fast bike for sure.
No question, and he's showing a wheel to Fitzgerald at the end of the fast back straightaway, cutting in on him, but Fitzgerald's gonna have the inside when they get to the top. we talked about a lot less ruts here. The rider's able to hang it out and come in with a lot of speed and carry that speed right through the corner. But I love what I'm seeing on the inside. Knowles, a little contact. Fitzgerald paddling along. Two real fast bikes out here. Way to their own little war up front.
Number 19, Cara Fitzgerald, has really come on late in this MX2 class, late in the season, Brian. He won at Sandalie, and he's been up at the top package. Look at him bust Knowles wide and off the track. Boy, you want to talk about bar banging. You see it here in the MX2 class. Love it.
Fitzgerald, a classy rider. All the guys like him in the pits. He's not a jerk. He doesn't do stupid things on the track. A lot of respect, and that goes a long way in this sport, especially when we talk about longevity. This guy's got some staying power. It's his third year in Canada, and he's showing well and poised to win the overall here.
Spencer Knowles falling back into third place, and he's got the number one of Eric Nye hot in his heels up through that long straightaway into the back straight, Brian. Boy, they carry speed out here, and Nye's giving it out there. He's giving it all.
He's got to redeem himself from that first moto. He fell three times in one moto. Never a good thing. First moto winner there, Kyle Beaton sitting in 11th as we get back to the lead package track. Spencer Knowles, he is in trouble right now with the wide line choices. Nye just knifes up the inside. Spencer Knowles, though, gaining huge experience this season.
That right-hander into that elevator section, Brian, is so choppy and not a lot of flow in that rutted package. I still like the inside line. Back to our leaders. Medaglia now, number 16, has made his way up to Knowles' back tire. Oh, my goodness, a little bit of contact there. And here's that new section of the track that you were talking about.
Well, Medaglia's coming in so fast, he almost went right into the back of Knowles. He kind of like had to hit the brakes and hit the brakes again. He almost cleaned right into him. Number 14, Teddy Mayer, in a great spot right now, observing this, but I think the aggressor right now, number 16, is going to make it happen. Sure enough, he does. He rides this track so well. Didn't get the greatest finish in the first moto traps, but he was one of the fastest men out the track.
Number 14, Teddy Mayer, starting to make his way into this package. Gets by Knowles on the inside. Forgot to say that number 24, Nick Evenot, now sitting in second place. So we've got a nice little cluster up here with some of the big names.
Yeah, Knowles like a pinball out here, bouncing all over the track. I'm liking what I'm seeing from Aaron Harvey right there, the last bike coming into our screen. Sixth place takes Knowles for fifth. He came from not a great start, really showing some speed here. The last moto, now is the time, man. You're only as good as your last act. These guys have the pressure on to finish well, so the teams remember who the heck they are when they go to sign their teams for next year.
This is for second place, the number 24. Oh, Nick Evenot with a beautiful line. You see that the line that most riders are taking over that natural double, nice and shiny on the right-hand side. This is for second place, as we said. Evenot in second, Nye in third. Coming into that cross-up section, down through the trees, Brian, to the wall. Wall hit. Oh, another square up. I love that part of the track.
This part of the track has been great for passing. There goes Eric Nye. No! Evenot's got the advantage on the inside, but Evenot low slides. Nye takes it. You know, in that corner, you got to do a lot of things right to get through it. You do one thing wrong, you're down. Boom, Evenot down.
Remember, number 14, Teddy Mayer, has clinched the championship. This is all just points and money. What a pass by number 16, Jeremy Medaglia, on that Murphy Motorsports RNC 250. What a pass.
You see Medaglia look over his shoulder to see if maybe he took Nye down. Looked over the wrong shoulder, Nye already crisscrossed. So he can hear him there, he can feel him, he knows he's there. But I think Medaglia has the confidence to know he's a bit quicker here in this moto.
As we talked about the number 72 of Spencer Knowles falling back a bit, now he has the number 21 of Jared Allison with a great line on the inside. Two young, great Canadian MX pilots battling on this Walton track, Brian. Love to see it.
The Allisons, I think, have a new confidence this year with the Blackfoot backing. They are riding like a Blackfoot rider should. Battle for second now, getting super hot. Medaglia right there. We know Eric Nye's not giving up. Really got to give a shout out to Eric Nye. He gets past and he pushes hard to stay there. But Nye's got other things to worry about with that number 14 bike right there, his nemesis.
Again, a dynamite cluster for third place, Brian. We're talking about an intense battle through the later stages of this moto. Look at all the fans up in here, and they are being treated some dynamite. Whoa. Oh, my, Mayer goes to that inside line and has a little bit of wheel spin. Drops the bike almost. Still in contention.
The tree people had a great view for that, and there's shade in there. A real hot day here in Walton. But our leader right now, Cara Fitzgerald, doing everything right. Here it is again. Nye comes around, taking a similar line. Look at this cut in. A little optimistic. a stick for Teddy Mayer. Looking to feed off the peg, still manages this little brap double, but what a ballsy challenge by Teddy Mayer.
It looked like he was trying to scare him into position, like, hey, I'm coming in, and yeah, then maybe man. Nye was gonna get on the binders. Here comes Nye, left-hander before the finish, up and over as they scrub down into the valley. Great elevation at this track, Brian. This is the section that Nye has dialed. He loves that inside line. Let's see if he takes it.
Unbelievable,
yes.
And he takes it right back from Jeremy Medea. Now Jeremy back on the gas. Oh. This is one of the best races on the racetrack. Lappers, heads up, get the heck out of the way, man. We got a freight train of leaders coming through. Teddy Mayer, a great view of this battle. And look at that shiny spot. Like I said, that is the line of choice for the takeoff. But upon landing, you can go inside or out. And I'm loving the tree section. Lots of inside, outside, and passing opportunities for the guys that want to get rough and tough.
The number 12 of Kyle Beaton starting to make some moves as he gets up to what is ninth place, the number 22, Brock Hoyer, on that leading edge Kawasaki. Look at the options in here, Brian, as Beaton goes inside and busts Hoyer wide, coming up to the Walton wall hit.
Beaton, trouble in the second motos. I think it's his conditioning, obviously, with his dismal start to the season, not being able to practice. You know, he raced with that broken wrist, but he was never on the bike during the week to try and get that thing to heal. So Kyle Beaton has had a lot of challenges this year. Like to see him do well, and he is coming back from a poor start in this one.
Look at the intensity we have for third place. We saw Nye coming around. He is in second. Let's wait for it. Eric Nye in second place. Jeremy Medaglia in third, and the number 14 of Teddy Mayer in fourth.
Usual suspects up front for the last moto of the year, and Medaglia showing his switch from a 450 to a 250. A wise move, Travers. Rides that little bike, I think, with a lot more conviction.
Well, he's just a small lad out there, Brian, and, you know, sometimes that big bike can be a handful. As we get back to Eric Nye, who is on the gas. It looks like he's pressuring for the lead. Here comes Medaglia in third place. We've got Teddy Mayer for low, and Nye's got a problem.
Slides out before the natural double. Can you believe that last lap? Eric Nye, talk about redemption. I thought this moto was his, you know, second place, and he had all the intentions of catching Fitzgerald. You could see how close he was, and there he is. He can't start the bike. Ouch, that hurts.
Sometimes, Brian, when you get into that position, you push a little too hard.
Right.
And, you know, Beaton comes over and gets his last lap flight, Brian. Still poetry in motion for that young Canadian pilot.
Yeah, without question, but the class of the moto, South African, Kieron Fitzgerald, finished the season in grand style with the win. Came on really strong last weekend. At Sandalie, takes the overall for the day. Way to go, Kieron. Welcome back to the Monster Energy Motocross Nationals. There's CERT team owner of Orange Motorsports. Gotta love the ride from Fitzgerald. Took the overall last weekend in Sandalie. First overall again. He is a hot commodity for 2010. Here's our moto results brought to you by Yamaha. Medaglia tough as nails in this moto. Gotta like the Allison boys in the top 10. Spenny Knowles and Brock Hoyer and Knife to the overall 2009 final standings. Mayer tags the championship, ousts Eric Nye. Aaron Harvey hangs tough. Fitzgerald beaten right there.
Please put your hands together for number 18 on that Red Bull Toyota Yamaha, Aaron Harvey. Come on in here, Aaron. When you started the season with two DNFs, I mean, you think to yourself, man, my season's gone. But it wasn't gone. You have to go one moto at a time. Got yourself a moto win. You've been battling in the top three, getting on the podium. That's the kind of stuff that your team likes to see.
Yeah, as far as the two DNFs go, I mean, I still had a huge chance to win the championship. But, you know, it was my own fault. I got stuck in the mud race, and just had some problems. Wasn't up there on the box. But I did the best I could, come up to get third, so it was good.
All right, finishing second in the MX2 class in the 2009 Monster Energy Motocross Nationals was last year's champion on that Royal Distributing 4 KTM. Put your hands together for the number one of Eric Nye, ladies and gentlemen. Come on up here, Eric.
You know, I was happy with the way I rode, but these last four races have been bad luck, and to win a championship, you gotta have good luck. Last year, I had awesome luck all year long, and, you know, it showed. I won the championship. This year, you know, Teddy rode awesome. Can't take nothing away from him. You know, he earned it. He was fast all year long. So, I can't complain too much. Second place isn't nothing to complain about. I mean, I'm disappointed, but I'm still happy, you know, for second place.
Number one, Teddy Mayer. Leading edge Kawasaki.
first place in the MX2 class this season. There's that plate. Beautiful stuff. Now, Teddy, you've had almost a whole day to bask now after that first moto when you did the clinch. It's really sinking in now. You got that plate in your hand. How does it feel?
It's amazing, you know. I come close a lot of times, but to finally do it, man, it's amazing. It really hasn't sunk in yet, but I'm pumped. You know, I came in kind of not 100% at all, struggling with a leg injury, and I knew I'd get better every race, and I did, and it was consistent. I had one bad moto with a water pump propeller that broke, and my bike locked up, but to gain the points back that I lost, you know, is amazing.
There you go. All right, let's get this thing going. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our MX2 champ of 2009, Teddy Mayer.
Meeting Edge Kawasaki, Teddy Mayer, fourth year in Canada, is a charm, takes the championship. MX1 boys, next.
Welcome back to Walton, Ontario, the home of the ninth round of the Monster Energy Motocross Nationals. Mark Travers and Brian Koster in the booth. The Julies are out on the track, and this is the final moto of the season, Brian, the second MX1 moto of the day, and it will be brought to you by Zox Motocross Helmets. Look at Kyle Keith getting all fired up on the line there. I love that.
All the riders have their own little idiosyncrasies, their own rituals as the gate goes to five. The nerve, doesn't matter how many times you line up, you are so nervous. The nerves go away right now, and the adrenaline kicks in. Travis, look at number three. Tyler Minagli with a great start. And grabs that world distributing hole shot, but it's number one. Colton Fassiani just storms through and grabs the lead right away.
That outside line through that Yamaha Sugar Bowl, very smooth, Brian, for Fassiani. I see the number 77 of Ian Hayden in third place, but he's got some trouble on the outside. Is that Kinnear? Yes, it is.
Great start for Hayden, you know. First race back, he's not really used to mixing it up, but he's holding his own. Once a racer, always a racer. Dusty Clad around the outside. Outside turns into the inside. Ooh, and he gets a little bit knocked around in some reps. Hayden holds on for now.
Brian, you talked about once a racer, always a racer. That's the one thing I like about number 77, Ian Hayden, a snowcross star, former factory KTM guy in here, hasn't raced a lot, and here he is right in the mix. I love it.
Yeah, it's all about line choice, picking lines, and not being intimidated or afraid, and he'll have none of that. Hayden, a tough competitor, making his fortune in snowcross now, so it's nice to see him back in the dirt.
The number three of Tyler Medaglia is sitting comfortably in second place, and his nemesis, the number 102 of Bobby Kinnear. Remember, they were vying for third place on the podium, and they're right now back-to-back over the Monster Scrubber.
Too little, too late for Medaglia. I think Kinnear's going to have a big problem for him to secure third, because Kinnear made up a lot of points in Moto 1.
The fastest man on the track in the first moto was number two, Dusty Clad, and he's got designs on fourth place as he looks for that inside line on the wall hit. Yes, he does. Does he have Aiden over the double into that off-camber section? Brian, Dusty Clad will not be denied, and boy, he's still pushing it early.
Yeah, even though he goes sideways, still manages to correct, holds on tight, ducking for the roost. Talked about the roost being a problem here. Mason Phillips, he had that problem in the first moto. He's sitting just behind these leaders.
Did you see Fassiani wheel around the corner? Holy smokes, he is on the pipe to Medaglia. And then back to Hayden. We've got Phillips and the number 108 of Cornell Nemeth. Look at the size of that monster, Brian, on the KTM.
Nemeth makes that 450 KTM look like a mini cycle. He is so good. There's Phillips, one of the biggest guys we have on our circuit. Look at Nemeth. The Terminator just rallies around the outside. And look at the way he can push on the bike. And look how big he is. It looks like he's riding an 85, for crying out loud.
Unbelievable. He swings by Hayden, and now he's got Phillips in his sights. And you're right, a giant man on the motorcycle. I mean, a lot of these guys are big, Brian, but he makes them all look like chips.
6'4", 240 pounds. You're not going to find a lot of fat on that body. Another thing about Nemeth, he was a freestyler. Did some of the biggest freestyle competitions all over Europe so he can handle the motorcycle. Right now, Dusty Clatt, using his favorite place to pass, takes care of Canary. Solid in third right now, Travis.
Looks like the pressure is on Phillips as the number 108 RTR Performance Orange Motorsports KTM of Cornell Nemeth with that inside line. Oh, Phillips has the problems, but Nemeth's on the gas.
The Terminator Nemeth can manhandle that bike. He didn't finish the first moto, Travis. Got a rock in the eye, smashed right through his goggles, and took out a contact lens. So Nemeth had traveled the long way to Canada to have a dismal first moto, but look at him on the machine. Oh. He is king on that KTM 450.
Handling that rough inside line. You saw your leader, number one, Colton Fasciotti, just destroying this track in the lead, then Klatt, and then back to this package. Here comes the number two of Dusty Klatt, working up on the number three of Tyler Medaglia for second place, coming into his favorite part there, Brian. Medaglia on the outside, Klatt looming on the inside, looking for that square up, coming up for that double on the inside line. Does he have him, Fabs? Oh, no, Medaglia gets on the gas, outside to inside, makes it happen.
Dusty cut up a lot of ground, but what we say in motocross, catching is one thing, passing is another. And look at the tenacious riding of Medaglia, just throwing it into the berms. And Medaglia, not a big guy on the 450, but he is strong and tough. But Drouz, the Terminator, is taking care of Canary, and look who he's hunting down now.
Holy smokes, he has made this battle for second place a three-pack. You talked about the ability, the tenaciousness of all three of these riders. Dusty Klatt right now is in a tough position because he's got Medaglia up ahead, but he's got the Terminator on the outside.
And the Nemeth has had Klatt's number several times this year. Second moto at Gopher Dunes, Klatt was able to hold him off, and there's Nemeth's favorite place to pass. And I'll tell you where Nemeth is gaining his track position. It's on the corner entries. He's coming in so much faster than everyone else, getting that big body of his and pushing the front end down into the dirt. And then he leans back, and he's getting wicked hooked up in traction. Nemeth wants to race in Canada next year. I tell you, if he does, Klatt and Fasciotti are going to have to do their homework.
Well, he's
going
to have to get some starts, Brian. Here's the pass on Klatt. Again, line choice, inside better. But what I like about Nemeth is how he uses the whole track coming out of the corner.
Right here as he settles in, that's where he pushes the front end down. Also gets his leg way forward to add weight to the front end. And he just puts himself in front of Dusty, and that's his favorite place to pass. Once you put yourself in front of the guy, hey, the other guy's got way less options.
Well, and he's forcing riders wide. That's what I like about it. Here's the pass on Canary, Brian, using the same part of the track, but an opposite entry into the corner.
Yeah, he can do it from the inside or the outside. Doesn't matter. That's where he makes his move. And look at the size of the guy. How do you deal with that? And I tell you, Dusty Klatt knows he's got to be in better shape if he wants to beat Fasciotti. We haven't had a chance to see Nemeth and Fasciotti go head to head. I think Fasciotti may have the measure, but Nemeth, if he can learn how to start his bike, man, oh man, he is championship material.
You're right, off the gate, difficult for such a big man on a 450 motorcycle right now, looking for second place on Medaglia. Remember when Medaglia went down here last year in this particular part of the track? Nemeth on the outside, look at him carry speed. And you're right, Brian, force that front end down and make that corner happen.
Nemeth doesn't care, inside, outside, look at him working the brakes, just beautiful. Tyler's thinking, hey, I can poke in the inside. Nemeth is protecting it. He is a crafty rider. He's got that European mentality. He likes to go fast.
Fabs, the Hungarian is schmooze. He's just got to get a good start and get up into that mix if he wants to battle with Fasciotti. Now sitting in second place. And there is our soon-to-be champion, Brian, through the trees. Let's just watch the majesty.
He rides so well, uses every bump to his advantage. Everything he seems to hit all transfers into forward drive. I'm telling you, Fasciotti is a threat in the U.S. if he can go down there and not be intimidated. He is running the U.S. pace, no question.
We just saw the number 103 of Jack Carpenter get by the number 9 of Mitch Cook for 7th place. We've got the number 5 of Kyle Keith in the fray, so some good battles going on late in the moto to our leader, number 1, Colton Fasciotti, on his final approach, Brian, getting ready to take the checkered flag for his 11th moto win of the season. Total dominance, back-to-back number 1 plates for Yotes.
Well, he came in so strong, saying earlier, him and Kyle Beaton trained in Georgia with JSR. Harvey and Klatt were on their own in California, and I really think Klatt needs JSR there as his mentor if he wants to touch this man, Colton Fasciotti.
This guy, the name that has got the whole shot, the second MX-1 moto, Team OTSF Suzuki. Get your hands together for Tyler Medaglia, everybody!
T-Dag!
Higgs with the $200 road distributing whole shot, final moto of the season. Let's go to our Yamaha leaderboard in our top 10. Kinnaird tucks in for fourth. O'Farrell with a second fifth of the day. Carpenter in sixth. Medaglia all the way to seventh. Keith finishes eighth. Phillips in ninth. And Mitch Cook at 10th.
To our final standings and our top 10 numbers for next year. An injured Paul Carpenter manages to hang on to fourth. Medaglia has to settle for fifth. A great season of racing for these guys. To the Max Couche-Tard $50,000 shootout. Colton Fasciani wins the 10 grand plus 2,500 for most moto wins. And on top of that, they get the series money and contingency money.
He's third place in the MX1 Championship. Let's give it up for Bobby Cannary, everybody. Right here, Bobby. Right on, number three plate, buddy. Good stuff going on there. Bobby, hey, a solid day. You came in here with one goal in mind, and you accomplished it.
Yeah, you know, I really wanted to pass my teammate Paul. He was unfortunately out this weekend, which gave me an opportunity to gain some points on him. And I really just wanted to have a strong, consistent day, and I ended up doing that. I really was chasing Dusty at last moto. I wanted him just for the sake of it, but he rode a good race. Everyone, Colton, congratulations on the year, man. That was a good job. And it was a fun year, man. I had a great, great time this year.
Dusty's coming up already. All right, put your hands together for Dusty Klein, everybody! There you go, Mark Stolle Rouse, the CMRC president, coming in, giving that up second place. If you could look back and maybe make one change to the thing this year to make a little, get a little closer to Colton, or even just make yourself feel better. Obviously, getting second is amazing. If you could just change one thing, what would you do?
Kind of wish I talked to my trainer a little earlier than I did, but I mean, after I started working with her again, you know, Mia, she helped me out a lot with just kind of getting my lungs back into a little bit better shape than they were, for sure. I mean, Colton's fitness was definitely a little, obviously, better than mine this year, and I kind of seemed to only be the one moto guy. I kind of wish I could have got some sweeps, but I mean, that's the way it goes, and we're gonna just plug away this winter and hopefully try to do a little bit better.
He's just earned his second title for the second year in a row. Put your hands together. Toyota, Yamaha, Red Bull, Fox Rider, Blackfoot Racing's Colton Fasciani! There it is, buddy. Raise that plate up right there. This is what it's all about, motocross right there, race fans. Right there, that's what it's all about. At what point in the season did you know that you were gonna regain this number one plate?
I don't know, I think I went into the series really strong, and that really helped me out. You know, I did my homework, and it really paid off. And through the middle there, Dusty and Paul actually got a moto from me, so you know, it kind of lit a fire under my butt to push a little harder and finish the series off good.
For $10,000 from the Max Couche-Tard sponsorship, Craig Devito, Paul Rack from Monster Everly. Craig getting nice and tight, get some pictures here, photo opportunity, guys. $10,000 going to the number one plate holder here, Colton Fasciani, plus another $2,500 for the most moto wins.
Well, there's only one other rider in the country that boasts a collection of King of Walden swords, and that's JSR. And now there's also Colton Fasciani.
There you have it, buddy. Grab that sword. The King of Walden, everybody, in 2009 at the World Transcan.
And there you have it, the 2009 Monster Energy Motocross Nationals, brought to you by Motovan.com, your source for power sports parts and accessories, and RoyalDistributing.com, Canada's power sports leader. For Mark Stolle-Brass and the CMRC crew, thank you very much for watching. Colton Fasciani is your repeat champion in MX1, and hey, congratulations to the Yotes.